The first two, I would say, are some of the two most distinctly different characters, but we'll ask them if they agree. But they're also two of the most beloved characters in Walking Dead history. So let's please welcome to the stage Mr. Cooper Andrews! And now, you know who is Morgan. Please give it up for Lenny James! There are, as usual, microphone over here, there's a microphone over there. Come line up and you can ask your questions to these guys. It's your one chance.
My question is for Lenny, and if Morgan hadn't met Eastman the Cheese Man, would you think he would still be alive? And if so, would he have still kept killing people like he was?
Oh, I think if Morgan hadn't met the Cheesemaker, Morgan would still be out there like a crazy man. People will be telling mythical stories of the crazy man who lives out there and talks to himself and burns people. I genuinely think if he hadn't met Eastman, he would have been doomed. I don't know whether or not he would be alive or dead, but I think he would be wishing for one and praying for the other.
So how was it like staying in that apartment? Does it have running water? What's going on?
Yeah, it's very nice.
Is it? Really? With all the writing on the wall?
Yeah, well, you don't stay in that room, it's like connected.
Oh, okay.
It's like one room and then you go to the next one.
Oh, okay. There was a weird thing when Scott was writing He Is Not Here, he wanted the kind of echoes of Clear in his head. So he asked me to do a recording that he put to music. I think he put it to Radiohead or something like that. But it was, I had to, in Morgan's voice, read everything that he had written on the wall. So there's this radio track playing over there, and then there's me kind of going, Dwayne's gone. And all that, apparently that helped him, but he was writing.
God, he's so creepy, man, he's so creepy!
Dwayne, turn.
That was such a great episode, one of my favorites, and I'm wondering just what it was like working with John and Carol Lynch.
Working with John Carol Lynch was amazing. I mean, the fact that we got him in the first place was just amazing because he's like the busiest man in Hollywood. But also, I think I've said this before, but it's kind of slightly underestimated how hard he had to work on that episode. If you go back and you look at that episode, he does all the talking. Literally, virtually all the talking. I think I say, I don't know, five or six lines the whole episode. The rest of the time, he's the one talking. And he also had to get good at the stick. In 3 days that he was good enough to look as though he was teaching me. And by that point, I'd been working with the stick for 7 months. So I think on a number of levels, outside of the amazing actor job he did and the fantastic cheese he nearly made, I think what he did and the fact that he was still standing at the end of it is a real testament to his talent.
Yeah, he's amazing.
What's your favorite moment that you've had working on the show? The second one is, like with Morgan and his staff and Jerry with his axe, if you guys would have to give a name to them, what would that name be?
Tori Amos is the name of the axe. Name your stick. What is the name of your stick? Do you have
We had a poll and I think it came out as we're just going to call it the Big Fella.
I got lots of names for my sword. It's if the sword is in the staff, it's Big Daddy Kane. If the sword is out and it's the shiny metal one, then that's Captain Jack Sparrow. If it's the rubber sword, then it's Jack Jr. And if it's the one that's cut in half when I'm stabbing someone and we have to fill in the rest with CG, I believe that's Half Jack. So I got Captain Jack, Big Daddy Kane, Jack Jr., and Half Jack. Got a lot of names in the songs.
What would be your favorite moment so far with working on the show?
It's hard to say. It's hard.
I love my job. It's hard to say. I mean, the first moment that that I was on set, actually standing next to Lenny, and my wife was reminding me, you know, in this whirlwind to take time to have a moment, I was sitting there. The pigs, you remember the pigs being corralled?
Yeah.
We that was our first shot, and we were sitting there waiting for the pigs to come running towards us because they weren't gonna yell action. When the pigs came towards us, we were gonna start hurting them in the other direction, and that's just when it started. There was kind of this quiet, you know, waiting for the wrangler to get the pigs together. And the wind was kind of, you know, whistling through the trees. And I looked over at Lenny and I said, "Lenny, it's my first shot." And Lenny said, "Welcome to the family." And the pigs came in and we were off. And it's been kind of like that ever since.
Every time I'm next to people with lots of pads, I feel safe. But that first day was great, and we had this scene that was through this moment that was taken out where Ezekiel and Jerry clothesline like three or four walkers with a ladder. He grabs one side, I grab the other, and then we push him off, and then I swing an axe at this walker, and I go boom. Take him out, and that's when I told the story before, but Nick Prox, he goes, Did you use the rubber axe? And I go, "Yeah, the rubber axe." And his face went,
Lenny?
Oh, do you know what? There's loads of fantastic moments if you've been doing it as long as I have. I think the most recent one, well, there's one coming up, but in order for me to tell you, it would be spoilers and I'd lose my job, so I can't tell you, but it involves this guy. But the one I remember from the last was in the season finale last year, and this wasn't one that kind of read, it was when I was reading the script, And myself and Melissa were on a plane either back from New York or heading to New York, and we were reading episode 16 of last season. And at one point, Melissa was ahead of me on the reading of it, and she just went, "Oh my God!" I went, "What? What?" She goes, "You'll find out." And I read through the script, and I got to the moment, and I was like, "Oh my God!" And she went, "I know!" And it's when Shiva arrives in the helicopter. That moment just brought it. A tiger, spoiler alert. What it usually is it was our head of special effects, Victor, with a tiger's head held in front of him, just dancing around the set, just kind of going, "Then he'll land here." And the fact that in the script we know it's going to be Shiva, but in reality it's Victor with a tiger head doing it, just made it all the better.
Kari, is that true? There's no Shiva.
Of course there's a Shiva.
That's what I thought.
Stop reading the internet.
But she is real.
I keep her in my pocket. She's amazing.
Hello, what's your name?
Hello, everybody. My name is Kanye, and I'm from Atlanta. And I'm inspired by all your acting, because it must be hard to remember all that. And my first question, because I have two, is if you could resurrect one character, who would it be?
I bring back Abraham. I bring
back Lynn. I'd probably bring back Denise.
You know what? I said that, and then I remember that Sasha's gone too, and now I'm just like, "Whoa!
I was interested.
We got this power, just give it to us.
I was interested you didn't say Morgan's wife. That's what I thought you were going to say. But I guess that would change the
story. Way to call him out.
she went out killing my son. That one was not moved.
And as always, thanks for watching, guys, and don't forget to subscribe for more Dead Stuff.